South Africa came through decades of political injustice, the apartheid system, which crippled people's both hearts and minds, as well as their economic and social prospects. It separated families, it broke up whole communities, and we are trying to reconstruct this country where now 4 million families live in shacks made out of tin and cardboard and literally anything people can find, including plastic or anything else, completely undignified, unfit for human life. And we have, as a result of this, huge unemployment, huge levels of malnutrition, we have children dying of starvation, we have a massive AIDS crisis as a result of the migration that comes from people coming out of the rural areas looking for work in the cities, and we have a huge, massive skills shortage in South Africa. So Cida is really about the needs of 87% of the population who do not go on post-school into any form of higher education, vocational education, and to give opportunities to those people to get them out of these shacks, out of these rural areas, to live a dignified life once they've been educated, either to build their own business or to get a job where there are tens of thousands of jobs, hundreds of thousands of jobs, but that cannot be filled because we do not have the skills.
Growing up in Katlehong is really difficult, especially if you have big dreams and big aspirations. To start off with, the community and the society in general accepts failure. You know, it's not a bad thing for you not to go to school and finish your matric or go to tertiary. It's not bad at all. You know, you just become one of those.
I was raised by a single mom, by a single parent. My mom, Margaret Shabalala. My dad passed away when I was 8, and things were pretty tough. I mean, especially regarding finances. Orange Farm is a very, very, very poor area with over 60% of the population unemployed. But fortunately, my mom was employed and she was an entrepreneurial person. So we were able to get our basic stuff. We lived in a shack for 2 years, and then my mom eventually was able to build a 3-room house.
You know, because everything about the township screams inferiority, inferiority. You know, you live in a house that's overcrowded. You have to accept that going a day without eating is part of it. It's okay, because really poverty cripples the people. Especially in my township, it's bad. It's horrible.
The growing up in the township is tough. It's really tough. There's not much role models, you know. It's mainly the role models are people who, you know, it's thugs and gangsters who rob people and they drive flashy cars and all of that.
I mean, you look at the young people my age, already they have children, and it's not because they've planned that. It's just, you know, it's poverty. Poverty cripples.
I've had a passion to see myself improving my life and the life of my family. But it was such a far-fetched dream. I never thought it would actually materialize and actually happen. So I've always wanted to be a better person in my life and to make my family and my community a better place.
When I got the acceptance letter from Cida that I was going to be studying towards a Bachelor of Business Administration, for 4 years, I knew it right there and there that I have just begun my journey to become a successful person.
What is thrilling is that as we sit here today, we've got 2,800 students who've come through. These kids would never have had another opportunity, and if you add up all of their salaries, next year they will be earning, it's 140 million rand, which is about 20 million US dollars in annual salaries next year. Now, if you think that that goes back to build houses for their parents and directly to uplift the younger brothers and sisters, sometimes they're, you know, a children-headed household where they are going to be the head of this household, bringing up the younger brothers and sisters and buying them school uniforms and putting them through school, it's immeasurable. This transformation that it brings in these families. And over and above that, every one of our students has to, as part of their degree, go back and teach in their community. So we end up reaching a huge number of people. We've taught over 600,000 people throughout South Africa about AIDS and HIV, about how to stay healthy, about how to start a business, about how to plan your career. And we teach computer skills, mathematics in the schools, etc., through our students. So there's this massive outreach. impact of Cida. And then after graduating, students continue to help their communities. But what they also have to do is within 5 years, sponsor another student from their community, even if it's their brother or sister, to come through Cida, and so that they can also get an educational or vocational program.
Trans Children's Home is an orphanage home housing 92 kids. You know, my involvement here brings a lot of pride, happiness, you know, fulfillment inside me. And it just spending some time with them, just doing something for them, knowing that it will in some way benefit them, it gives me so much joy, and I cannot even explain it in words what I feel really inside.
Cida has an incredible relationship with TransUnion, and even when I think of the company, I just feel such incredible, almost emotion, because of what they've done for this really beautiful thing that we're doing here. But the faith that they've taken, and I mean, could you think of a company in the world that would give away 10% of their equity in perpetuity, basically for nothing, to empower the youth of this country that have no real opportunities? And so that every single day when a TransUnion employee goes to work, they know that 1 rand out of every 10 that they make that day is going to support the poorest of the poor to build a new life for them. And so it's an unbelievable thing they've done. I mean, it's unheard of. You would not, you know, come across companies that would do this kind of thing.
TransUnion thus far employed 8 Cida graduates. We've put plans in place to increase this number in future. The partnership, I must be honest, with Cida has been absolutely phenomenal. We have this pool of well-trained individuals that adds value to our company, not just add value to our company, but who is integral to the economy as a whole. TransUnion obviously want to create more opportunities for these graduates, and by so doing, we want to give them and provide them the necessary skills that they enable to develop their talent. And because what we found out is that it's one thing having a qualification, but it's a completely different thing in the true world out there in reality, because it does not guarantee job prospects in the future. So what we're trying to do is provide them with the necessary skills so that they can improve their lifestyles, their family lifestyles, and the country as a whole.
Yeah, Cida is the awakening for Africa. Cida takes the poorest of kids around from around Africa and builds them up into these great future leaders, and leaders with great vision, extraordinary leaders, people who have the betterment of the African people at heart.
I believe in divine interventions, in divine connections, and it's not by accident that TransUnion has taken into itself to supporting Cida students to become better people. It is part of the divine plan, it's not a mistake. And nothing is more beautiful than knowing that there are people who believe in you, who believe that you can be a better person, and just getting that push in the right direction is the most beautiful.